Hello students, in my previous class I discussed about taxonomy, systematics and hierarchy of classification of living organisms. Because classification as proposed by Carlos Linnaeus considers various aspects such as external appearance, internal organs, cellular details, the interaction of the organism with the surroundings, and also evolutionary aspects of the organism. And classification is not a single stage process. Classification involves categorization of the classification stages into different hierarchical taxons, which are in ascending order: species, genus, family, order, class, phylum or division, and kingdom. Species is the basic unit of classification, and we go up in the ascending order to reach the kingdom. And kingdom are again classified into five kingdoms, which you are familiar with. In every category, in every taxon, we find a group of organisms with similar characters. We shall study every taxon in this hierarchy with suitable example. But before that, you should understand in nature what is seen is the species. The remaining thing are the classification of it. The taxonomic categories we have assigned to it. In nature, what you find is the individual species. To it, you have assigned a genus, a family, an order, class, phylum, and kingdom. That means in nature, you find species only. Remaining taxons are assigned to it. Starting with species. In the Linnaean hierarchy, the basic unit of classification is species. Species refers to a group of organisms that are similar in appearance and they reproduce among themselves to produce a fertile offspring. We know that horse is a species, donkey is another species. Because from the external appearance, we can identify which this is a donkey, this is a horse. Even they reproduce, the offspring, which is called mule, is not fertile, it is sterile. That means species refers to a group of organisms with similar characters and breed among themselves to produce a fertile offsprings. And species is the basic unit of classification. Taxonomic studies consider a group of individual organisms with fundamental similarities as a species. Human being is a species. All the human beings on this earth are the same species. There is no subspecies. We cannot consider any human of any country as superior to somebody else. Biologically, all human beings on this earth are the same species. See the slide. A family of African elephants is seen. The elephant represents a particular species. They are all basically similar. They reproduce among themselves to give birth to a fertile offspring. All organisms, including those in plant and animal kingdom, have species as the lowest category. Whether any kingdom you see, in all the five kingdoms, Monera, Protista, Mycota, Plant and Animalia. In the hierarchy of classification, species is the lowest category. That's why we call it as basic unit of classification. One should be able to distinguish one species from another closely related species based on distinct morphological differences. Yes, I told you donkey is a different species, horse is a different species. By external appearance, we should be in a position to understand this is a species, that is another species. When you look at a wolf and a dog, you should identify this is different, wolf is a different species, dog is a different species. In the same way, when you see the neem tree and a mango tree, you have to identify the morphological differences, external appearance differences has to be identified for the different species. Human beings belong to the species Sapiens, which is grouped in the genus Homo. Hence, the scientific name of human beings is Homo sapiens. Homo refers to the genus name. Sapien refers to the specific epithet or species name. See the classification of human beings. Species, single human being. All species belong to the species Sapiens. As we go up, different closely related organisms keep on joining. Because ultimately we fall under animal kingdom. All are animals. We also fall under animal kingdom. Kingdom Animalia. Phylum Chordata. Because we have backbone. Oh, many, many chordata are there. The other phylums are there. Non-chordate phylums are there. Porifera, Coelenterata. Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes, Aschehelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Urochordata. And we come under class Mammalia. We are all mammals. From rat to elephant, we find the same class. Order primates, monkey family. So there is a systematic classification for human beings also, similar to any organisms. Species is the basic. As we go up the taxon, we get different similar organisms being added there. Genus. Human beings have the genus name Homo. In the same way, every organism has a genus name. The first name in binomial nomenclature is genus. Genus consists of a group of related species. Related species comes there, which has more characters in common in comparison to species of other genera. We shall see the example. Let us consider Mangifera indica. Mangifera indica, you know, it is a mango tree. Solanum tuberosum, potato plant. And Panthera leo is lion. A mango tree, a potato plant, and a lion. They, which are totally different from each other. Different species. Look at the name. Mangifera indica, Solanum tuberosum, Panthera leo. You see the second word in these names. Indica, tuberosum, leo. What does it represent? It represents the specific epithet that they are different species. Whereas the first word, Mangifera, Solanum, Panthera, what does it indicate? It indicates the genus or genera at the higher level. When you consider the genus, I told related species comes there. Panthera is a genus name. For lion, see lion, leopard and tiger. Lion, leopard and tiger. The three, you know, at least you know the difference between a lion and a tiger. Both are different species. From the appearance, they are different. They cannot reproduce naturally. So, lion, leopard and tiger. Look at the scientific name. Lion is called Panthera leo. Leopard is called Panthera pardus, and tiger is called Panthera tigris, with several common features. All the species of the genera Panthera. The genus is same for lion, leopard and tiger. That is, Panthera is same. Species is different. For lion, it is leo. For leopard, it is pardus. And for tiger, it is tigris. When you consider a cat, cat is not the same genus. Cat is in the same family, but not in the same genus. This genus, Panthera, consisting of lion, tiger, leopard, differ from another genus called Felis, which include cats. Consider the example. Solanum is the genus name. Three plants we have. Solanum tuberosum, common name is potato. Solanum melongena, brinjal. Solanum nigrum, mokai. They are different species but have some similar character, so they are coming under the same genus Solanum. See the another example which you have considered. You are finding a lion, you are finding a leopard, you are finding a tiger. All the three have the same genus Panthera, but they are different species. Because they have some similar characters, they are coming in the same genus. Cat is different, so it is coming under different genus. Each genus may have one or more same specific epithet representing different organisms but having morphological similarities. For example, lion, leopard and tiger. Different species under the same genus because they have many similar morphological characters. Another example, genera are aggregates of closely related species. What is genus? Closely related species are there, sir. They have same genus but different species name. For example, potato, brinjal and mokai are three different species belonging to the same genus Solanum. See, a potato plant, a brinjal plant and mokai, which the village children are familiar with, all the three are different species. Because they have some similar characters, they come under the same genus, Solanum. Leo, Panthera leo, lion, Panthera pardus, leopard, Panthera tigris, tiger, with several common features are all species of the genus Panthera. But this genus differs from another genus Felis, which includes cats. After species, genus, above that we get the family. Family has a group of related genera. Genera had related species. Family has related genera with still a less number of similarities as compared to genus and species. Families are characterized on the basis of both vegetative and reproductive features of plant species. When you look at a plant,
the root, shoot, leaf are the vegetative characters, whereas the flower is the reproductive characters.
In a family, we come across different plants. Belonging to different genera, but they are in the same family because they have some similar characters. For example, among the three different genera, Solanum, Puccinia and Datura are placed in the same Solanaceae. A family called Solanaceae has different varieties of plants. But they have some common general characters. In the same way, in animals, genus Panthera, there we come across lion, leopard and tiger, is put along with the genus Felis in the same family Felidae. Felidae has both cats and panthera. But dog is not there in this family. Dog family is different, which has the wolves, fox, wild dogs. Cat and dog are separated into different families. This cat family is Felidae, whereas a dog is, dog has a different family, Candidae. See, the Felidae has a group of larger family which is called cat family. So species, genus, family, above that comes the order. In order, different families come together. Categories like species, genus and family are based on a number of similar characters. Generally, order and other taxonomic categories are identified based on aggregate of characters. Different characters, organisms come under order. Here, different families joined together because family A and family B, both are different families, but they have similar characters, so they come together in order. Order is an assembly of families. Different families come together, which exhibit few similar characters. The similar character is less in number as compared to different genera included in the family. The two different families in an order are much different, but the two individuals in the same genus are almost similar. See, order Carnivora. It has a dog family, it has a cat family, it has a bear family. So in order Carnivora, we find different varieties of families joined together. The animal order Carnivora includes family like Felidae. And Canidae. Felidae includes cat family. Canidae includes the dog family. Both are there in the order
carnivora. What about human beings? The order of man, monkey, gorilla, gibbons, chimpanzees, apes all come under primates. This is our order, including individuals of different families. Above that comes a class. All this comes under the higher class called mammals, in case of animals. Carnivore are different, primates are different, but they are under the same class, mammalia. Class includes related orders. As we go up the hierarchy, we keep on adding different individuals with similar characters at the bottom level. Class includes related orders. Orders included related families, isn't it? So, order primata. Just now we told, consisting of monkeys, chimpanzees, gorillas, gibbons and human beings. He is placed in the class mammalia along with the order carnivora, consisting of tigers, cats, dogs. Because class mammalia includes all the organisms which have hairs on their body, and they drink milk when they are young. Above this you find the phylum Chordata, which is again divided into pisces or fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals. We are talking about the different classes, and class mammalia is where we come. So mammals include a wide varieties of organisms, from rat to elephant, including the gigantic largest living animal, the blue whale. Phylum or division. Remember, the word phylum is used when you are talking about the animal kingdom. Division is used when you use the word when you are considering the plant kingdom. Class comprising animals like fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds, along with mammals, constitute next higher category called phylum. Different phylums fall under the kingdom Animalia. All these are based on common features like presence of notochord, dorsal hollow neural system are included under the phylum Chordata. When you study the lesson Animal Kingdom, you will be studying the general characters of the phylum Chordata. At that time you will study all the animals having the notochord, the nerve cord, pharyngeal gill slits fall under the phylum Chordata. In case of plants, different classes with some similar characters are grouped together to form a higher category, not called as phylum, called as division. In case of plants, we don't use the word phylum, we use the word division. These are the chordates.
Now the kingdom. All the animals from poriferans, sponges, to man, all come under the same kingdom, Animalia. There are totally 5 kingdoms. The highest category in taxonomic hierarchy is kingdom. The lowest category in taxonomic hierarchy is species. All animals belonging to various phyla are assigned to the highest category called kingdom Animalia in the classification system of animals. The kingdom Plantae is distinct and comprises all the plants of various divisions. As we go higher from species to kingdom, ascending order, higher from species to kingdom, the number of common characters keep on decreasing. As you come from up to down, the number of similar characters keep on increasing as you go from down to up. Because in animal kingdom, I come under animal kingdom, a rat come under animal kingdom, a cockroach come under animal kingdom. How much different me and a cockroach is? Totally different, but we fall under the same kingdom. As we come from up to bottom, from kingdom to species, similar characters keep on increasing. As we go from bottom to up, species to kingdom, similar characters keep on reducing. Lower the taxa, as you go down, more are the characteristics that the members within the taxons share. Higher the category, greater is the difficulty of determining the relationship to the taxa at the same level. Hence, the problem of classification becomes more complex. In animal kingdom, we find wide varieties of organisms. So, we have to start from bottom and go up so that we can get the different characters of different species. Ultimately, there are 5 kingdoms, classified based on different characters. Kingdom Monera, including prokaryotic organisms like bacteria. Kingdom Protista, consisting of unicellular eukaryotic organisms like protozoans, amoeba, paramecium, euglena. Kingdom Fungi or Mycota, consisting of the yeast, the mushrooms. Kingdom Plantae, consisting of plants. Kingdom Animalia, consisting of animals. Dear friends, this is the chart you have to write and practice. This is a chart that is present in the textbook. Four examples are given. Common name of man, housefly, mango and wheat. Two from animal kingdom, two from plant kingdom. Man and housefly from animal kingdom, mango and wheat from plant kingdom. They are the common name. What is the biological name? Man is called Homo sapien, you know. Housefly is called Musa domestica. Remember, genus name is always started with capital letter. Species name is always started with the small letter. They are underlined separately when handwritten. Mango, Mangifera indica. Mangifera indicates the genus name. Indica refers to species name or specific epithet. Wheat, the biological name. Wheat is common name. The biological name is Triticum aestivum. Look at the family. Human being belong to who? Hominidae, order primates, class mammalia, phylum Chordata, kingdom Animalia. In the same way, the remaining three also, all the four examples of man, housefly, mango and wheat. This chart you have to write. How many times you write? Either 3 times, 5 times or 10 times is left to you. But write until you are confident of answering. If I ask you, for example, mango, which class it belongs to? You have to tell immediately, dicotyledony. Housefly, which order it belongs to? Dipterian. In second PUC, there is a lesson. Dipterial insects. Diptheria. Diptera, it is. Is an order of in which you find the housefly. If I ask you the family of man, you have to tell Hominidae. So you have, how many times you write is secondary. Write until you are perfect. Neat questions come from it. Lastly, I am concluding the lesson with the same picture as in the previous slide. 5 kingdoms. Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. See this video 2 times, 3 times. Read the content in the textbook. Write the important points. Write the terms, tough terms. Practice yourself and empower yourself so that you will be competent. Okay, children? See you in the next class. Until then, please take very good care of yourself. God bless you. Thank you.